5:00.
I signed up, but I didn't get to speak. I just have something to read.
Vice Chairman?
She left before.
I'm meeting a lawyer too.
Oh, yes, if we.
May I? Thank you so much. My name is Sheila Kimball, and my granddaughters are the 10th generation of people living right here all that time. And I just want to say that in '86, I noticed that my Alamo hero's name was not engraved on the Capitol grounds of Alamo Defenders Monument there. So I called the State Board of Preservation, and I was told that, we're aware that there are a lot of errors there, but people that were present at Alamo weren't on there, and vice versa. And I said, well, what can we do? We can, you know, my family will pass the hat, we'll get some money, and we'll put our ancestor's name on there. And I said, no, in and of itself, it's its own, has its own historical precedent now. And so, all right, fast forward, here we are, the Alamo Cenotaph. Now, back then, it was 95 years old. In '86, it was 95 years old. Not the Cenotaph, but the monument on the Capitol ground. That Cenotaph, also called the Spirit of Sacrifice, having been erected in '36, has been in place for 84 years. And Copini himself selected the site specifically, got the ground deeded to him, so by the city of San Antonio and the state, so it always remained its proper place, there, right in front of the chapel of the Alamo, where those men defended and died for this new republic. Now, the CEO, the board of the Reimagine the Alamo, and the whole board, the General Land Office, they're real anxious to move that cenotaph. And why? Why are they so anxious? At some point, they're placing their own best interest ahead of the most revered site on our Texas soil. I just don't think many Texans would cotton to that, you know? It means too much to all of us to let it become a Disneyland. So, please, please, take care of our cenotaph. Don't let them move it.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing.